So hello dear students, let me start the third method of biasing, that is collector feedback biasing, right? This is also known as collector to base biasing, right? So the earlier method that I have discussed was emitter resistor biasing, right? In that method, the stabilization of operating point is, or you can say it was improved by inserting a resistance in emitter, right? Just look the last video. Now here what I am going to do, I am introducing a feedback from collector to base, right? I am introducing a feedback resistance from collector to base, right? So here I have connected a base resistance, right, between collector and base, right? So the stability of operating point in case of collector feedback biasing can also be improved by the introduction of feedback from collector to base. How? Let me discuss further. So first of all, see here, I have connected a resistance RC in the collector, right? This VCC is a battery, right, which is connected here, right? This RB is a base resistance connected between collector to base, right? Current in collector is IC, current in base is IB, right? Similarly, current in emitter is IE, right? So now let me discuss further. If this is current, collector current IC, and this is base current IB, tell me what is the current in this branch RC. Apply Kirchhoff's current law at this node. When you apply Kirchhoff's current law, you will get that sum of incoming current is equal to sum of outgoing current. Sum of outgoing current will be equal to sum of incoming current. That means what is the value of this current? This current will be sum of this current plus this current. That means IB plus IC, right? And this IB plus IC is nothing but emitter current IE, right? Now let me take the outermost loop, apply KVL in the outermost loop, that means in this loop, apply KVL in this loop. So when you apply KVL in this loop, that means apply KVL in this loop like this, right? Apply KVL in this loop like this, right? Start from BCC, go to ground. When you apply KVL like this, you will write VCC, start from VCC, minus, in the direction of current flow there is a voltage drop. That means what is the polarity of voltage drop in RC? Like this, plus to minus. So VCC minus IB plus IC into RC minus IBRB, right? In the direction of current flow there is a voltage drop. That means positive here, negative here. So in the direction of current flow, the last point will be negative. That is the meaning of drop, right? That is our basic convention of electrical technology. So here write minus IB into RB, minus IB into RB, minus plus to minus VBE, right? Minus VBE is equal to zero, right? So now further simplify this. You know this, we know that IC, collector current IC, is beta times of IB, right? So put this IC here, you will get VCC minus, in the bracket write IB, 1 plus beta. Put this value of, put this value IC is equal to beta IB here. Take IB common, you will get this IB 1 plus beta into RC, right? Minus IB RB, write remaining terms as it is, right, is equal to zero. Now rearrange the terms. VCC minus VBE is equal to IB in bracket RB plus 1 plus beta times RC, right? Further calculate IB. VCC minus VBE divided by RB plus 1 plus beta times RC. Are you getting this? Right? Or you can also write IC is equal to beta times of I base current IB. That means you write beta VCC minus VBE divided by RB plus 1 plus beta times of RC, right? So this is the collector current, right? Now I'm going to apply KVL in collector to emitter loop, right? Apply KVL here in collector to emitter loop. So this is basically collector to emitter voltage, right? Apply KVL in this outermost loop, in this collector to emitter, like this. So when you apply KVL in collector to emitter loop, you will write VCC minus IB plus IC into right RC minus VCE, right? VCC minus IB plus IC into RC. What is the drop in this RC? I into R, Ohm's law. So I is IB plus IC into this resistance RC. Now plus to minus, right? Plus to minus, plus say minus ja rahe ho, last mein sign kya raha hai? Negative. To last wala sign aapko yahan lena hota, right? Minus VC minus that is equal to, sorry, 0, right? So that means VCC minus IC plus IB into RC minus VCE is equal to 0. Or you can also write VCE is equal to VCC minus IB plus IC into RC, right? So like this, from here, these data RB, beta RC, VCC and VB is given to you. Calculate IC from here. And once you calculate IC and IB, you can also calculate VC, collector to emitter voltage. That means the operating point, you have calculated IC and VC. This is the operating point you have calculated, right? Now, what is the advantage of this method? See here. This biasing stabilizes the operating point against the variation of temperature, right? Against the variation of temperature and also against the variation of beta. Suppose if your beta changes, right? If beta changes, collector current will not change. See how? In denominator, see the expression. What is the expression? RB plus 1 plus beta RC. So this 1 plus beta RC is greater than RB. If you see the numerical questions, you will come to know that this RC into 1 plus beta is greater than base resistance RB. So can you ignore RB? Answer is yes. So when you ignore this RB in denominator, you will get 1 plus beta RC beta, right? 1 plus beta is approximately equal to beta, so 1 plus beta get cancelled with beta. So what is remaining? IC equal to VCC minus VBE by RC. That means, now tell me, is IC depending on beta? Answer is no. So that means IC is independent on beta. So that means if you change beta, that means if you replace the transistor, if you replace one transistor with the another transistor, right, your collector current will not change. And also, this biasing method is stabilizing the operating point against the temperature variation. So this is collector to base biasing, right? That is the advantage, okay? And the disadvantage, you can say, if you decrease base resistance, then the collector to base junction will decrease, right? So this biasing method is considered to be better than the earlier two method because of these two reasons. That means it stabilizes the operating point against the temperature variation, and it also stabilizing the operating point by against the variation of current in beta, right?